The three tier system of Panchayat Raj. In this video, we will study the three tier system, that is Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti, and Jilla Parishad, and its functions. First, that is Gram Panchayat. Under Panchayat Raj system, the role of Gram Panchayat is very important. The progress and development of village depend on it. It is called the pillar of Gram Swaraj or Gram Suraj. Under this new act, villages with 5,000 to 7,000 population and the adjacent small villages joined together to create a Gram Panchayat. Every 400 resident will have one representative and they are elected by voters whose age is above 18 years and the term of office in 5 years. It is expected to meet at least once in 2 months. Functions of Gram Panchayat. Taking care of health and sanitation of the village, providing pure water for drinking, provide drainage and street lights, housing, establishing khadi and village industries, providing elementary education and etc. Now the Taluka Panchayat. Every revenue taluka will have a Taluka Panchayat. It consists of the elected members of the Taluka Panchayat. For every 1,000 person, one representative is elected from the rural areas. In addition, the local members of Legislative Assembly, members of Legislative Council and members of Parliament are also members. Besides, 1/5 of the president of the Gram Panchayat are appointed on rotation basis for a period of 1 year. Then functions of Taluka Panchayat. To prepare the annual plan and budget as suggested by the government or the Jilla Panchayat. Prepare agricultural extensions programs and request for grants. Conservation of soil and land developments. Promoting the use of non-conventional energy sources. Promoting primary, higher and technical educations and etc. Now, third tier, that is Jilla Panchayat. It is one of the important units of Panchayat Raj system at the district level. And members for every 40,000 people is elected for Jilla Panchayat. But in case of Malnad, hilly areas, one member is elected for 30,000 people. In addition, the members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha who represent the district and the members of legislature are the members of Jilla Panchayat. Gram Panchayat presidents are also its member. Now see the functions of Jilla Panchayat. Extension plans for agriculture and horticulture. Use of water resources and its maintenance. Use of non-conventional energy. Women and child welfare programs. Social developments of the disabled and mentally retarded, helping regarding room and library developments and etc. These are the functions of Jilla Panchayat. Now the municipal local bodies. These are created to look after the welfare of cities and towns. There are three kinds of town municipalities, city municipalities and corporation. Town and city municipalities. They are constituted for a population of 10,000 to 50,000 in towns or cities. Such a city municipality council will have 15 to 35 elected members. In practice, they are called councillors. Even there is a reservation for women SC/ST. The term of this municipality is 5 years. Functions of towns and city municipalities. Maintenance of underground drainage, public gardens, playgrounds and cleanliness. Taking care of roads, street lights and sanitation. Provide relief in case of natural calamities. Maintenance of birth and death reports. Extension and beautification of city. Supply of drinking water and etc. Now you see, municipal corporation or Mahanagarpalika. They are created where the population is more than 2 lakhs and income is more than 1 crore rupees. The number of members is decided by the state government. The membership may vary from 50 to 100. The complete city is divided into wards, and from each ward, one member is elected. The term of corporation is 5 years. To help administration, an administrator is appointed by the government. The administration of the Mahanagarpalika is carried on by 3 wings. First, that is general body or council, standing committees, and commissioners.